Okay, let's start. We will study today a new topic. Okay, introduction to Boolean algebra. Right. So, how this is helpful for us? Okay, I will say. Before stepping into this topic, I would like to say, I will give you one scenario. Okay. Automatic, let's say, where it finds application. Okay. I am taking one scenario. Yeah, is it visible and audible now?
Yes, sir.
Okay,
Yes, sir.
right. So I got my pen. So let's discuss a scenario. Okay, automatic. Say irrigation system. Okay, automatic irrigation system means usually students will come for project in the final year. Okay, and they tell us we will be doing automatic irrigation system or automatic lock the door when you are driving a car. Any, I will take two random scenarios today and explain you that these scenarios, how we can put it into some logic. Okay, how to extract logic out of this scenario. Okay, let's say automatic irrigation system. I have three fields here. Okay, I have three fields. Let's say I have a field here, right? And the cultivation here is wheat. Okay, wheat. And I have another field here. Here we cultivate, say, rice. Okay. And we have another field here where we cultivate, say, millets. Right. So I have taken three fields here, three farming fields are there, where in the first one we would like to cultivate wheat. Okay. Second one, rice or paddy cultivation is going on, and in the other one, millet. So the purpose why I have chosen these three is wheat require much water. Okay, water requirement is more. Okay, so for wheat, then rice require little less compared to wheat, and millets require negligible amount of water. So what we do, I will put some sensors here. Okay, I will put some sensors. Okay, let's say some figure I'm drawing. I have here three sensors. Okay, in the wheat field, I have installed three sensors. It will sense the, I mean, how much water content is available in the soil. Okay, and give us some output. Okay, the sensor will give us some output if the field happened to be dry. Okay, so three sensors are deployed at three different parts of the field. Three different sensors are deployed at three different parts of the field where wheat cultivation is going on. Understand the scenario. Okay, where wheat cultivation is going on, three different sensors are there, and those sensors work or task is if the water moisture in the soil is getting less or the soil is getting dry, it will give us a signal, right? Similarly, I have three sensors here for rice. Okay, I have three sensors for rice field also. And I have two sensors for millets. Okay, two sensors for millets. Now, what is my objective is if the my field, okay, cultivation field gets dry, okay, any part of the field, okay, any part of the field, if it gets dry, I would like to switch on a motor. Okay, I would like to switch on a motor. That is my output. Okay, the output or objective is to switch on motor, okay, or switch on motor, or you can have ringing a bell, or you would like to send a text message, whatever. Okay, so if these activities happen here, I want this to happen. Okay, if these activities happen here, I want this to happen, right? So how to put it, this scenario, into some useful logic? Okay, how to put this scenario into some logic? So we will be doing it, we will be answering this. Okay, so say wheat, let us put it in Boolean logic. Okay, let us put it in Boolean logic. Okay, or using binary logic. So I have three sensors here. Okay, so let me name them. For wheat, I have three sensors. Let's say this is A, this is B, and this is C. Okay, I have three sensors, A, B, and C. So let's analyze one by one. Okay, let's analyze one by one. So this is my wheat field. I have sensor A, sensor B, and sensor C. Okay, I have sensor A, sensor B, and sensor C. Now, if any part of the field gets dry, any, either A or B or either C or three together, okay, or two together, okay, if this is the scenario, then I would like to switch on the motor. Okay, if this is the scenario, I would like to switch on the motor, right? If any part of the field is dry, I would have to switch on the motor. So what I will do, I'll make a table. This is A, this is B, this is C. Okay, so let's represent the sensor output. If the sensor gives an output 1, means field is dry. Okay, if 0 means field is wet. Okay, understand? 1 means dry, 0 means wet. Okay, so if all 3 are 0, means what? There is adequate water in my field, so I need not switch on the motor. Okay, this is output. Okay, why output means what? Motor, 0 means off. Okay, motor should be off. When it is, y is equal to 1, motor is on. Okay, so this 0 means what? Motor is off. Okay, let me write it here. Y 0. Okay, y is equal to 0 means motor is off. Motor is off. Y is equal to 1 means motor is on. Right? Now, let's come to the this part. If this is 0, this is 1. Let's say B sensor is at one part of the field and it raises an alarm or raises a signal. Okay, the sensor gives a signal 1. Okay, sensor gives a signal 1. Sensor can give either two signals, 1 or 0. In Boolean logic, we have two things only. Okay, binary logic, either yes or no, 1 or 0, 1 or 0. 1 means the field got dry. Okay, but a sensor is sensing that at this part of the field, okay, it is, this part of the field is wet. Okay, and B sensor part got dry, and C is also, let me write in this way. Okay, this is 0, this is 1. Okay, C detects some dryness. Okay, then it should be 1, right? Then B detects dryness. Then also I should switch on motor. Okay, then these two detect dryness, I should switch on. Then A detect dryness, B and C didn't detect. Okay, how many possible scenarios are there if three variables are there? We will be having 8 possible scenarios.
8.
Right. So 1, 0, 1 means A and C detect that there is dryness. So then 1, 1, 0, A and B detect there is dryness. Then all three detect that there is dryness in the field. Okay. I should switch on the motor. Right. So when the motor will be off, when the field is wet, when the field is wet, when all three sensors say that the soil is having adequate moisture in it. Okay, right, that is 0 0 0. All of you understood this one? We are discussing the wheat field. Okay, for wheat field, if any part of the sensor or any part of the field senses that there is dryness, I would like to switch on the motor. Okay, I would like to switch on the motor. So this is the tabulation. Okay, this is the table, right? This is the table. So this logic we would like to implement. So we will see what fits to this logic. Okay, now let's go to the paddy field. Okay, let's go to the paddy field. Okay, here you see the second one, rice. Okay, let's go to the rice and make this is the rice field. Okay, rice field. So here also I have three sensors, let's say A, B and C. Three different sensors are there. Okay, so here one sensor, here another sensor, here another sensor. Right, three different sensors are there. So I would like to switch on the motor as like wheat only. Okay, so if any part of the field gets dry, I have to switch on the motor, because paddy and wheat, they require more water. Okay, without water it is difficult to harvest. So what in automatic systems we would like to switch on the motor, if any part gets dry or the sensor senses that there is a dryness in the soil, I would like to put water in the cultivation field. Okay, so let's put here same thing. This is A, B, C. Okay, three sensors. And Y. Y represents motor. Okay, functioning of the motor. Okay, so Y zero as usual. Y is equal to zero. So Y zero indicate motor is off. Okay, Y is equal to one indicate motor should be on. Right, so let's say A senses wetness, B senses wetness, C senses wetness. Okay, so I need not switch on the motor, right? If A senses wetness, B senses wetness, C senses dryness, I should switch on the motor. Okay, if A senses wetness, B senses dryness, C senses wetness, okay, I should switch on the motor. If A senses wetness, B and C both senses dryness, I should switch on the motor. Okay, similarly, if A senses dryness, B and C don't sense dryness, okay, I should switch on. Okay, if A senses dryness, okay, B don't and C also senses dryness, I should switch on the motor. Okay, right, all three senses dryness. Okay, I should switch on. Is it clear? The table is clear to all of you? Is the table clear? How I am writing? See, a real-time scenario, I am putting it into logic. Okay, this real-time scenario, I am putting into some logic. Okay, right? So, these are the, input parameters. Okay, this is what output means. This is output. Okay. Sorry. This is output. Output, our output means what here? Output means switching on the motor. Okay, switching on the motor. Or you can have your own desired output, right? Let's go to the millet field. Okay, now you can see here three fields are there, right? Let's go to the millet field. Okay, now you have millet field here. Okay, so how many sensors I have taken? Let's check. I have two sensors here. Okay, or let's say I will take for convenience one more sensor. Okay, three sensors are here. Okay, as usual, A, B, C, and let's put it in table. Okay, three sensors are there as usual, A, B, and C. Okay, here is one. Right. Three sensors are there. And for millet cultivation, little water is adequate. Okay, we don't require much water, like paddy and wheat. Okay, like rice and wheat, we don't require plenty amount of water. So what is my objective here? If either A senses dryness, or either B or either C, any one of them or any two of them senses dryness, it is not required to switch on motor. Okay, so my objective is what? If all three senses dryness, whole field is dry, I would like to switch on motor. If a part of field is dry, I don't want to switch on motor. Okay, you can see the objective here. Okay, so for wheat case, what? This scenario, see, all are one, means what? A is sensing dryness, B is sensing dryness, C is sensing dryness. So here, A senses dryness, B senses dryness, C senses wetness. Okay, I'm switching on motors, right? For all these cases. If anyone, at least anyone, is sensing dryness, I'm switching on the motor. See here, anyone, I'm switching on the motor, right? So, but for the millet case, what I will do? For the millet case, if all three senses dryness, then only I would like to switch on, right? So let's make table for this, right? Let's make table for this. This is A, this is B, this is C, three sensors, and I have my output. So as usual, Y is equal to zero, okay, means it's off, and Y is equal to one means on the motor, right? On the motor. On the motor, right? So let's say A senses A zero means what? Let me write here. A is equal to zero means A is sensing wetness in the field. Okay. So A is equal to zero means field is wet. Let's say this is part of A, this is part of B, this is part of C. Okay. So here field is wet, right? So similarly, A is equal to 1 means this part is dry. Okay, understand? So A is sensing wetness, B is also sensing wetness, C is also sensing wetness. I need not switch on my motor. Okay, now A is sensing wetness, B also wetness, C is sensing dryness. I need not switch on. Okay, last class I used to switch on, but I don't want here. Because I am cultivating millet, much water is not required. So I need not switch on if any part of the field gets dry. Okay, I have taken some random scenario. Okay, so let's say this is sensing wetness, B sensing dryness, C sensing wetness. I need not switch on. Okay, so this is 0, 1, 1. Means A sensing wet, B, C sensing dry. I need not switch on. Right, so what will happen? This will be also 0. Okay. Now, when A is sensing dryness, B is sensing dryness, C is sensing dryness, I should switch on the motor. Okay? I should switch on the motor. Right? This is my table for millet. Okay? This is my table for millet. Now, how to put it in circuit? Okay? How to put this logic in circuit and how to optimize this? Okay? That is what Boolean algebra helps us. Okay? That is what Boolean algebra helps us. Okay. Just have a view to this table. Okay. This is the input part, right? And this is the output part. See, for what input combination, what is the output? Okay. Right. So the scenario is clear to everyone, right? So we have three types of field available with us, right? First field require much water. Second also require much water. If any part of the field, okay, if any part of the field is sensed dry, we should switch on the motor. But for the last case, what is happening? For the millet case, if all parts are dry, then only we want to switch on. So we got a different table for the last one, right? Now how to put it into a Boolean expression, okay, or some sort of algebraic expression, right? So let's see. We have one operation called as not, okay, or negation, not get. We call it as not get. So it is usually denoted like this, okay? It is usually denoted like this. So this is the input, okay? I have written A, so output will be A bar, okay? Output will be A bar. So if the value of A is 0, if the value of A is 0, output will be
1.
If the value of A is 1, output will be 0. Okay? This is called as not logic. Okay? So I guess you people might have studied a little bit in first year. Have you studied in first year basic electronics? Was this topic there for you? Anyone respond?
Right now it's there in FDLC, sir. In the previous year we have it, sir.
Okay, right. Okay, it's called as not logic. Okay, let's say we will go to one more logic. Okay, we'll go to one more logic and I write it as AND logic. Okay, AND logic. And let's say I have taken two input, A and B. I have taken two inputs, A and B. And I would like to express the output, Y. Okay. So what is value of Y? It is A and B. Okay. It is represented as A dot B. Right. So it is called as A and B. Okay. We don't read it as dot in Boolean. We call it as A and B, right? So if A is 0, B is 0, the output will be 0. If A is 0, B is 1, output is 0. If A is 1, B is 0, output is 0. If A is 1, B is 1, output is 1. Okay? Output is 1. So how it is represented? Let's see. And the electronic form, okay, two inputs we will show. Okay. So this is A, this is B, this is A dot B. Okay, this is the symbol, right? So let me draw it again here. This is the symbol, okay? This is called as AND gate. This is called as AND gate. So what logic? You can see A is 0, B is 0. You get the output 0, isn't it? So A0, B1, output is 0, right? A1, B0, output is 0. It means what? Output is high when both inputs are high. Okay. So for this, what we can write? The output is high when both inputs are high. Okay, this is what you're supposed to remember. Okay. Output is high when both inputs are high. Right. This is for two-bit scenario. Okay. Output is high when both inputs are high. Right. Let's next go to another logic. Okay. it is called as
OR.
Okay, let's say I have A as in one input and B as another input, right? A is one input and B is another input. And Y as the output. So Y we write it as A. Just a minute. A or B. We write it as A or B. Okay. If A is 0, B is 0, what will be the value of output?
0.
If A is 0, B is 1, we will be getting
1.
If A is 1, B is 0, we will be getting 1. If A is 1, B is 1, we will be getting
1.
Okay. So this is the logic. So what it does? So its representation, we draw it like this. Okay. This is A, this is B, output is A or B. Okay, A or B. These figures are important when we put circuits in pen and paper, right? So A or B. So output is what in this case?
Output is low. Both.
When both inputs are low, then only output is low. Okay.
Awesome.
So I can write like this. Output will be high when any one input is high. Okay. This is also correct. So output is low when both are low, or output is high if any one. Okay. Any one is high means this is high. At least any one. Okay. Is it clear? This is called as OR logic. Okay. Now we will move to another logic. Okay. We'll move to another logic called as, let's say, I will write it as A is one input, B is another input, and let's say this is Y. Okay. So I'm writing 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. Okay. 1, 0, 1, 1. So this is 0. Okay. Now I want that my output Y should be high when at least one input is low. Okay. My output I want high. Let me write. I want the output to be high when at least one input is low.
OR gate, sir.
Okay, not OR gate. See, OR gate is this one. Output will be high when any one input is high. Okay, so here I want output to be high when at least one input is low. So here at least one is low. Okay, so both are low. I want high. At here one is low. I want high. Yeah, this is low. I want high. When both are high, I want it as low. Okay, so what gate it is?
NAND.
Yeah, NAND gate. Okay, so Y expression is what? It is just inverse of AND. Okay, this is AND. You can see 0, 0, 0. Okay, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1. Okay, it's opposite of that. Okay. Right, so I will write it as A and B, its complement. Okay, A and B, its complement. We call it as what? This logic as NAND logic. Okay, we call this logic as NAND logic. So how do we represent? This is AND gate with a bubble. Okay, AND gate with a bubble, right? So if this is A, this is B, this is A AND B complement, okay? AND B complement, right? So we will see the usefulness of these tables, right? Now let's move to another one, okay? Let's say I have A, I have B, and I have some output Y. So this is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. Okay. So I want my output to be low when any input is high. Okay. I want my output to be low when any one input is high. So for this case, if any one input is high, I want it 0. This is also I want 0. This is also I want 0. But when both are low, I want it as 1. So what is this logic? This is
NOR gate.
Okay. Complement of OR gate. Okay. We call it as NOR gate. Okay. We call it as NOR gate. So how we represent? This is OR. Okay. With a bubble. So this is A. This is B. This is A OR B complement. That is A NOR B. Okay, A NOR B. So here, what we'll write? The output is low when at least one input is high. Okay, at least one input is high. Any one event, it triggers it. Okay, output will be low. I will give a wonderful example for this scenario. Okay, just hold on. Right now, with these tables, let's move to our first example. Okay, wheat field. Okay, what is this table? You can see 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1. Okay. If all three are low, okay, you are getting a low. If any one is high, okay, you are getting high. Which logic it is?
NAND.
NAND. You can see?
OR, sir.
This logic, isn't it? It is OR logic. Right, any one input is high, okay, output is high, right? So for the wheat field, what we have
OR
logic is A OR B OR C. Okay, this is the logic for wheat field. Okay, now let's go to the paddy field. Rice. Okay. This is also same, isn't it? This is also like OR gate only. Okay. So let's say OR gate. Okay. Rice field. That is also similar to A OR B OR C. Okay. Now let's move to millets. Okay, what millets are having? When all inputs are one, then only it is one. Okay, when all inputs are one, then only it is one. Which logic this is?
And sir, AND A dot B.
A dot B dot C. Okay, so for millets, we have A AND B AND C. Okay? Right. So, if you have A plus B plus C, A, B, C, we won't read it as plus. Okay, A OR B OR C for wheat field. For rice field, A OR B OR C. For millets, A AND B AND C. Okay. So, this is one set of condition, this is one set of condition, this is another set of condition. Okay, another set of condition, right? So I have named the sensors as same. Okay, ABC, ABC, ABC. So you can have ABC, DEF, okay, and next, okay, GHI or whatever, right? So if all these three, right, this is one event, this is another event, this is another event. If any of this one event occurs, then I should switch on my motor. Okay. If any one of this event occurs, then I should switch on my motor. So what I will write? What I will write? So let's say, just change of variable I am doing. This can be written as what? D or E or F. Okay. Change of variable only. This is what I can write. G and H and I. Okay. So I have nine different sensors. Okay. Nine different sensors. And these sensors working in some way should switch on my motor. Okay. So three different fields are there. If in any field water content is less, in any field, any one field water content is less, I would like to switch on the motor, right? So which logic you will be using? See, listen carefully. This field, wheat field, rice field, and millet field. Okay, we have three fields. In any of the field, if any of the field is having less water content, then I would like to switch on the motor. Anyone. So which table we will go for? Okay. You can see a table here. You can see a table here. You can see a table here.
Or, sir.
Which table you will go for?
Or.
Someone told or. Okay. See, anyone is one. Output is one. So or is the best choice, right? So what we will write? This cumulative expressions. Let me write here. So the total output Y is equal to, we will write A or this is B or C. Okay. This is one event, right? This should be OR with, this should be OR with taking D, E, F. This is for the rice field. Okay. Then or. Then you go for G and H and I. This is the expression of Y. Okay. This is the expression of Y. Okay. So this is D. Okay. Is it clear to everyone? So we have kept this real-time scenario into some logic form. Okay. A or B or C. Okay. Whole or with D or E or F. Whole or with G and H and I. Okay. Let's, I guess it is clear to all of you. Okay, let's move to another interesting scenario. Okay, we have 10 minutes quickly. I will tell you another interesting scenario. What you people are comfortable with sometime. Okay, let's see. We have one exam hall. Okay, exam invigilation room. Okay, we have one exam in visualization room. So listen carefully. We have two invigilators. Okay, two invigilators are there, and one squared is there. See, few factors I am writing here. Okay, two invigilators are there permanently, one squared is there, and another factor I am taking, exam preparedness. Okay, exam preparedness, exam preparation. Okay, so let's say two invigilators, I am naming them as A and B. Okay, one squared C. Exam preparation, I am taking a variable D. Okay, I am taking a variable D, right? So few people come with slips in exam. Okay, few people come with some slips in exam. There will be one interesting scenario. Okay, so if you do, okay, malpractice, or if you see anyone doing malpractice, how do they do? First, they will see whether invigilator is looking to them or not. Okay, we have two invigilators in our room. Okay, invigilator is looking or not. First, that fellow will take those inputs into account. Then, next, he will also look for squared, whether any squared fellow is coming or not. Okay, and the primary aspect is whether that fellow knows the answer of the question or not. Okay, exam preparedness. Let's say I don't know the answer of my question. Then I will look for what? Any invigilator is looking to me or not. Okay. If invigilator is not looking, I will also look for squared came or not. If all three events trigger, then I will open my slip and write. Okay. So how to put this in logic? Who will say? First, let's say invigilator case A and B. Okay. Invigilator case A and B, I'm taking some output as Y. I'm writing 0, 0, indicating that A value 0 or B value 0 means, invigilator is focusing on the student. Okay. Invigilator is focusing on the, or not focusing on the student. 0. Let's say A 0 means invigilator not focusing on the student. So I will write A 0. Okay, let me write here. A0, invigilator is not focusing on the student, right? So A0, B0, it is a good time to open the cheat. Y is equal to 1. Okay, so Y is what? What is Y? Open the slip. Okay, open the slip what you have. So A0, B0, none of the invigilator are focusing on you. You can open the slip. If anyone is focusing, you should not. Okay. If anyone is focusing, you should not. If both are focusing, you should not. What is this logic? What is this logic? Let's go to our table. What is this logic?
R. Okay. Complementary of R.
Complementary of R. Right. So it is what? A nor B. Right. If both invigilators are not focusing, then only you should open slip, or else you will be booked under malpractice. Right. Let's say another scenario. Okay. What was the another one? Squared fellow. Okay. So squared, I have taken a variable C for squared. Okay. C for squared. Now, if squared comes, okay. If squared comes, this is C, this is Y. Okay. Y is what? Opening the slip. Y true means what? Y is equal to 1 means open the slip. If Y is equal to 0, don't open the slip. Okay, don't open the slip. So if squared comes means what? 1. True. True means what? If squared comes, I should not open. If squared don't come, I will open. Okay, what is this logic?
Not.
Y is what? Complement of C.
Complement of C.
Okay, right. Then let's go to exam preparedness. I have taken the variable to be D. if you are prepared for the exam, you know the answer of the question, you don't require the slip. Okay, it will be inside the pocket or wherever you have kept, right? So let's say D is the variable. This is Y. Y is as usual, right? Y is equal to 0 means what? Y 0 means don't open. Okay, don't open slip. And Y is equal to 1 means you can open the slip, right? So if you are prepared, D1 means what? D is true means you are prepared. So slip not required. Okay. If you are not prepared, slip is required. So what is relation between this? So Y is equal to?
D bar.
D bar. Okay. Y is equal to D bar. Now, let's put this in terms of the equation, right? So what you will write? So Y I will write. Okay. Y I will write. A. Nor B. Okay. See, three events, all three should happen. Then only I will open slip. If I don't know my answer, I'm opening slip. If invigilators are looking, then I will be caught. So invigilator should not see plus. Okay. Squared should not come plus. I don't know the answer. Then I will be opening slip. This is invigilator is not focusing on you. Okay. Next scenario is what?
Plus.
Okay.
C bar.
Next scenario is what?
D bar.
So what you require here? A and operation.
R.
Okay. And operation. All three should happen. Okay. All three should happen. A and B. You can see. A and B. Okay. This one. Right. All should happen. Then only output will be one. Okay. If all three events happen, then only I will open my slip. Isn't it? If all three happens.
Okay, sir.
Okay, if all three happens, invigilator not focusing on you. Okay. And squared didn't come and you are unprepared. Then open the slip. If any one is one. Okay, if this value is one. If you are opening slip, you will be caught. Okay. So all these three should be true. Okay, all these three should be true. Understand? If any one is zero, if this is zero, you will be caught. Y will be zero. If this is zero, Y will be zero. If this is zero, Y will be zero. Understand? Just think of it once. Another scenario, I will just add to it. Okay, we have a couple of minutes. Let's say, in the same scenario, sometime in exam, you get a known person as squared. What you will do? Okay. So, see, I'm writing here A nor B. What does it mean? Invigilators not focusing on you. Okay. Not focusing on you. So, this is okay with us. Right. Now, you didn't prepare for the exam. Right. So, we will be having DVAR. So exam preparation. Okay, D bar is for exam preparation. But for the squared fellow, okay. Now when invigilator not focusing on you and you are not prepared for the exam, you don't know the answer, you have a slip somewhere. Okay. But some known invigilator, known squared person comes. Okay, C is the squared. Okay, known squared comes. Then what you will do? Sir, I will write something. Okay, you will open the slip and write because that fellow is known to you, he won't say anything. Right. So in this case, what will be the equation? So C, presence of squared gives you energy so that you will be copying. Presence of squared. Okay, you copy because squared is known to you. If squared is not there, okay, you don't copy. So what will be my equation now? So Y will be what? A plus B bar or A nor B along with this. Okay. Only C. Okay. Here what will be the relation? Y is equal to C. Okay. And D bar. Right. This is my new equation. So based on my scenario, I can put it in some logical equation. Okay. Is it understood? So.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, I have a network issue, sir. Can I log in and log in again, sir?
Yeah, you can.
Please allow me.
Right. So, based on our requirement, we have, based on the scenario, we can have our own logic developed. Okay. We can put it into our equation. Okay. So, y is equal to a plus b or a or b bar, that is a nor b dot c dot d. But for previous scenario, when the squad is unknown to you, squad will be booking you under malpractice. So you have a C bar here, but you have a C here. If a known squad comes, equation changes. Okay. I guess it is clear to all of you. Just have a look to today's lecture. Okay. I will be uploading it in the blog and YouTube. Okay. Just have a look. Go through it once. Then I will be telling you more information regarding Boolean things. Okay. How we will optimize these scenarios, such type of scenarios. Okay. Right. So it's going to be 3:00. Tell.
Sir, B10 students have some doubt in their exam, sir.
Exam question.
So exam question paper, sir.
Exam question paper, we will be handling it in some other class. Okay. I haven't received any question paper as of now. When I will be receiving all set of questions, I will take a special session someday. So we'll be discussing all the answers. Right. Regarding every issue related to exam. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
So we'll stop here. Thank you very much.
Yes,
thank you. Okay, sir. Patnaik, sir, name leave out.
Okay, madam.
Last one, plus C into D, kada?
Plus C.
Kada, A plus B whole bar. Into D plus C kada?
Into D plus E. Yes, madam.
Plus A plus B whole bar into D bar plus C kada antara?
Plus C. Like what statement we will write? Accordingly, it will change, I guess.